Hayling Island. Hayling Island is an island off the south coast of England, in the borough of Havant in the county of Hampshire, near Portsmouth. An Iron Age shrine in the north of Hayling Island was later developed into a Roman temple in the 1st century BC and was first recorded in Richard Scott's Topographical and Historical Account of Hayling Island, published in 1826. The site was excavated between 1897 and 1907 and again from 1976 to 1978. Remains are no longer visible and are buried beneath cultivated farmland. The first coin credited to Commius that was found in an excavated context was found at the temple. This Commius was probably the son of the Commius mentioned by Julius Caesar in his writings, although it's possible the coin was issued by the original Commius. Salt production was an industry on the island from the 11th century. The Domesday Book records a salt ban on the island for this purpose, until the late 19th century. Construction of Northwode Chapel by the monks of Jumieges, Normandy, began in about 1140. This became the present St. Peter's Church and is now the oldest surviving church on the island. It has been claimed that St. Peter's three bells, cast in about 1350, have one of the oldest peals in England. St. Mary's Church is a standard design of the churches of its era, but upon close examination the walls have been constructed from a mortar of local shells and beach pebbles. The ancient yew tree in the churchyard is believed to be the oldest yew in the country, with a girth of some. Although estimates as to its age vary, they range from over 1,000 to nearly 2,000 years old. The grave of Princess Yurievsky, 1878-1959, who was a member of the ill-fated Russian royal family and who lived in North Hayling for many years, may be found in St. Peter's Churchyard, and the grave of Scotsman George Glass Sandeman, nephew of the founder of Sandeman Port and second head of that company, is prominently featured in the northeast part of St. Mary's graveyard. The island was the location of a mock invasion during the military exercise Fabius in May 1944, rehearsing the preparations for D-Day. In 1982, British courts recognized prior art by Peter Chilvers, who was a young boy on Hayling Island, assembled his first board combined with a sail, in 1958. It incorporated all the elements of the modern windsurfer. The courts found that later innovations were merely an obvious extension and upheld the defendant's claim based on film footage. This court case set a significant precedent for patent law in the United Kingdom, in terms of inventive step and non-obviousness. The case, Chilvers, Hayling, and a replica of Chilvers' original board were featured on an episode of the BBC's The One Show in 2009. On October 20, 2013, at least 100 properties on the island were damaged when it was hit by a tornado. No injuries were reported. Hayling Island is a true island, completely surrounded by sea. Looking at its north-to-south orientation, it is shaped like an inverted T, about long and wide. A road bridge connects its northern end to the mainland of England at Langston. The Hayling Ferry is a small pedestrian ferry connecting to the east in the area off the city of Portsmouth on the neighbouring Portsea Island. To the west is Langston Harbour and to the east is Chichester Harbour. The natural beach at Hayling was predominantly sandy, but in recent years it has been mechanically topped with shingle dredge from the bed of the Solentine in effort to reduce beach erosion and reduce the potential to flood low-lying land. At low tide, the east winter sandbank is visible, extending a mile out to sea. The coastline in this area has substantially changed since Roman times. It is believed much land has been lost from the coasts of Hayling and Selsey by erosion and subsequent flooding. As with the rest of the British Isles and southern England, Hayling Island experiences a maritime climate with cool summers and mild winters. Temperatures have never fallen into double figures below freezing, illustrating the relative warmth of the island, comparable to the far southwest of England and its neighbour, the Isle of Wight. Temperature extremes between 1960 and 2010 have ranged from during January 1963, up to during June 1976. Hayling Island has a non-league football club, Hayling United FC, which plays at Hayling Park. Although largely residential, Hayling is also a holiday, windsurfing and sailing center, the site where windsurfing was invented. In summer 2010, the Hayling Island Sailing Club hosted the 2010 World Laser Standard Senior and Junior Championships, 27 August to 5 September. The Senior Championship was won by Australian Tom Slingsby, while Dane Torbjørn Skjæup won the Junior competition. Today it is a home to many different types of sailing, including a growing fireball fleet. As a consequence of the island's popularity for water activities, there are two lifeboat services, Hayling Island Lifeboat Station, run by the RNLI and Hayling Island Rescue Service, an independent service run by retired RNLI helmsman, Frank Dunster. The island hosts one of the few active real tennis courts in the UK. Founded in 1911, Seacourt Tennis Club is one of only a handful in the UK where it is possible to play every recognised racket sport. The rackets court itself was opened by Sir Colin Cowdrey. Seacourt Tennis Club also hosts a weekly fencing club featuring all ages, levels and weapons. Hayling Golf Club has been voted in the top 100 golf courses in the UK. A traditional links course, although relatively short by modern standards, the strong prevailing southwesterly winds, fast greens, gorse bushes and traditional deep links bunkers make this a stern test for any golfer. Funland, an amusement park situated at Beachlands, is open year-round, as is the East Hayling Light Railway which runs from the Funfair to East Oak Corner. The Hayling Billy Trail is a former light rail right-of-way which has been converted to one of many footpaths on the island. The Ordnance Survey Explorer 120 map covers the area and the local tourist information office supplies leaflets of local interest walks. The station theatre hosts a variety of plays staged by the Hayling Island Amateur Dramatics Society, Hayling Musical Society, musical events and films throughout the year. The island has several churches of different denominations including three Anglican churches, St. Peter's at Northney, St. Mary's at Gablehead and the more recently built St. Andrew's in South Hayling. Until March 2015, Hayling Ferry linked Portsmouth and Hayling Island. The ferry was busy in summer in good weather, bringing tourists and cyclists to Hayling. In winter, there was a significant reduction of use. The ferry service to and from Portsea Island was subsidized by the local authorities, leaving it under constant threat of closure due to limited resources. The ferry service ceased when the company running the ferry went into administration in March 2015. It was reopened in August 2016 by Baker Trite Marine Limited. During the ferry's closure, the only public connection between Hayling Island and the mainland was the single carriageway road linking Northney to Langston, Havant. In summer in particular this road can become very congested rendering the journey between the bridge and South Hayling, the most populated area anything from 30 minutes to an hour. A proposed millennium project to create a new shared pedestrian and cycle bridge was unsuccessful. A railway to the island was active in the 19th and 20th centuries. It opened on July 17, 1867, coinciding with the local races. Terrier steam locomotives pulled carriages along the Hayling Billy line from Havant Station on the mainland to a station which was located at the northern end of Staunton Avenue, passing through Langston where there was a halt. The railway was popular with tourists throughout the summer, though it saw little service in winter, and at peak times ran up to 24 services per day. Despite its popularity, the line was marked for closure in the Beeching Report due to the prohibitive cost of replacing Langston Bridge that connected the island to the mainland, estimated at up to £400,000 to repair. Services ended on November 3, 1963, and the bridge was demolished in 1966. The only remaining railway building, a goods shed, has now been converted into a theatre which is run by Hyatt's. A tourist attraction, the East Hayling Light Railway, is a gauge railway that runs for just over from Beachlands Station to East Oak Corner with aspirations to extend the route to Ferry Point within the next few years. The nearest railway station to Hayling Island is Havant, just onto the mainland off Hayling Island. Alternatively, Portsmouth and Southsea is another railway station, used for connections to Bristol, Temple Meads, and Cardiff. Oysters have been fished on the Hayling oyster beds, at the northwest corner of the island, as long ago as Roman times, documented in town records since 1615. The oysters were actively farmed between as early as 1819 until the 1970s. Oysters became a delicacy that was exported throughout the country under the classification of Emsworth oysters. Large complexes consisting of several pens separated by a series of bun walls and sluice gates were built to contain the oysters at varying stages of growth. Although large sections of the walls have since collapsed into the harbor, much of shape and scale of the beds can still be seen today. In 1996, the oyster beds on the northwest coast of Hayling Island were restored by the Havant Borough Council, creating a wildlife haven which has become an important seabird breeding site. The Design Council awarded this project Millennium Product status for the renovation. The island is the home of the Hayling Charity Cycle Ride which organizes an annual charity cycle ride most often from Hayling Island to Paris and back. This event, run entirely by local unpaid volunteers, was started in 1986 by local cyclist Peter McQuaid and has been run every year since. Up to 2018, over £1,700,000 had been collected for more than 500 good causes. Entrants have come from 15 different countries on 5 continents. In the mid to late 20th century, Hayling Island's population was known to double during the summer months, due to a large influx of holidaymakers and the associated tourism employees to accommodate. As domestic holidays have declined and Hayling's prominence as a traditional English seaside resort has followed in parallel, the population only swells by approximately 20% to 25%, English Tourist Board Estimate, 2001. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.